All right, so let's do this. We got a couple examples here, and we're going to get these two quadratics. We're going to get them graphed. We're going to sketch those graphs, and we're going to do that by factoring them first. So let's look at this one right here. This one is a little bit tricky if we're not paying super close attention. One thing I want to note, it's not actually written in standard form. So let me change this to standard form right now. Reminder, on a standard form for a quadratic, your leading term right here should have square on it. X to the second power. So the thing that makes a quadratic expression, or in this case, a quadratic function, is that the largest exponent is going to be 2 for that variable. And it's going to be ordered, each term needs to be ordered by their exponent. So here we got to put the x squared first, and then finally the 17x next, because this would be x to the first power. And finally, we'll put the 5 last, the constant last, because we don't see an x attached to it. That means technically this would be x to the zeroth power. So I did that there, and let's get to the meat of this here. We want to factor this, and again, the reason why we want to factor this is because we want to figure out what the x-intercepts are. So we'll do that right now. Because we don't have an a of 1, we have an a of 6 right here, we got to use our box method, box and diamond method, to quickly figure out what the factors of that quadratic is. So 6x squared times 5 would be 30x squared. I'm going to put the 30 there. We have 17x's to help us figure out the way that it's arranged. Two numbers that multiply to 30 and add to 17. Well, I'm guessing that it's going to have to be 15 and 2. So I was kind of thinking, 17 is about halfway up to 30. 15 is exactly halfway to 30. So let's try 15 first. 15 plus 2, yep, checks out. 15 times 2 is 30. 15 plus 2 is 17. So that means if we arrange 15x pieces right here and 2x pieces right here, we would know that this would make us a rectangle. And we can get our factors from this. So 2 would have to be down here.
2x goes into 2x one time, and 2x goes into 6x squared 3x times. And we can follow from here. 3x times 5 would give us 15x, and 5 times 1 equals 5. So those are our factors. And that's going to help us get the x-intercepts. That's what the whole goal of this is here. So if you remind yourself, well, I just factored this here. How's this going to help me get the x-intercepts? You got to step backwards and remember that thing we keep saying. The x-intercepts are the value of x when y equals 0. I think we just officially passed the 100th time we've said that in class this year. So maybe we don't need to make as big of a deal of that as we have been so far. So now we have this here, and we have a couple factors. We can use this to get the x-intercepts. First of all, if we know that this factor equals 0, that's going to get a 0 product. The 0 times whatever that would give us 0 here. So if we know what makes 2x plus 5 equal 0, and we know what 3x plus 1 would have to be for x to make this equal to 0, we would know what that factor would be 0, and we'll cancel out this factor here. So we're using the 0 product property to determine our x-intercepts. 2x equals negative 5, so x would have to be negative 5 halves here, or negative 2.5 for one of our x-intercepts. And the other x-intercept is going to have to be 3x equal to negative 1. Divide both sides by 3. X would have to equal negative 1/3. So those are our x-intercepts. We can sketch out our graph now. This is going to be pretty close. They're pretty darn close together, this one. And so I'll scale it out pretty big here. So I'm going to go all the way negative 1. Let's put negative 1 right here, x-axis, y-axis right here. And let's put negative 2 right here and negative 3 right here. So we would know on this graph that there would be one x-intercept at negative 2.5 and another x-intercept at negative 1/3 right here. And finally, a little bit hard to see. You could solve for the vertex. We're not going to do that right now, but let's put the y-intercept. So another reason why I wanted to change the standard form is that we see here our last term here, our constant term, that's of the standard form, that's going to be our y-intercept. So we'd have a y-intercept up here at 5. And then, so this obviously, the y-axis isn't scaled nearly as wide as the x-axis, but that's okay. We're just getting a sketch of this parabola. We have this here. We could solve for reverse x if we wanted to, but for the sake of time, let's not do it. Second example, let's do this one real quick. Is it written in standard form? Yes, it is. We're going to know we're going to have a y-intercept at negative 15, so I'm just going to put that on the graph right now. Feel free to do that. Let's say that this is negative 15. This is negative 10. This is negative 5. Give it some sense of scaling down here. So we have our y-intercept, and that's going to be at negative 15. Let's get the roots. Let's get the zeros. Let's get the x-intercepts. They're how many different things? They are the same thing. So first of all, to get our roots, that's the value of x when y equals 0. So I'll change to that first. Now we're going to factor. Generic rectangle, diamond, because our a here is not 1. There is not really a great way to do this in your head. Negative 30 is the top of the diamond, and the bottom is we have 7 x's to place. So we know that we have to get to negative 30, so that means that one of these numbers will be positive, one will be negative, and we put the negative right here. The larger of the two numbers, the one with the greatest absolute value, is going to be the positive number because we have positive 7 x's here. So we can think about this for a second, or we can think about just, you know, 30 doesn't have that many factors. I think 1 is 10 and another one's 3 would go into 30, but let's make 10 positive and 3 negative because 10 minus 3 is 7 and negative 3 times 10 is negative 30. And we can go ahead and place these pieces here. And we would know that's how we would set up a rectangle. We don't have to bother with those tiles anymore. Be thankful for that. We saw that enough through observation that this would have to be a rectangle. 2x times x is 2x squared. X times negative 3 is negative 3x. 2x times by 5, and everything checks out. We're good to go. Got our factors. X plus 5 times by 2x minus 3. And that's all equal to 0. So I just kind of flipped it around here. And using this, we can get our roots. Okay, x plus 5 equals 0, and that's really easy because if you just subtract 5 from both sides, we get negative 5 for one of our x-intercepts. So let's do that. I'll put that later just to see what this looks like. 2x minus 3 equal to 0. Add 3 to both sides, we get 2x equal to 3. Divide both sides by 2, x equals 3 halves. Or let's just make that decimal 1.5. So we have here our two x-intercepts. We have a y-intercept, that's enough to get a graph because we have two key features. X-intercepts, y-intercept, enough to sketch out the graph. Here, let's scale a little bit more widely here because this is a 1.5. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then here, negative 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 5 here. So here we have a root at negative 5 and a root at 1.5. Y-intercept right here, and this is going to look kind of funky. So one thing I might do on this one here is I might figure out where the vertex is, just to make my graph look a little bit more accurate. Vertex, your rule is here. You can take your roots here, remember, and that's going to tell you where the line of symmetry is going to be at x equals, and then the average of the roots. So I'm going to do 1.5 plus negative 5 over 2, and that's going to be 1.5 plus negative 5 is negative 3.5. So this would be negative 3.5 divided by 2. And if I do negative 3.5 divided by 2, use a calculator. You might be able to do that in your heads. But that's just going to be negative 1.75 is going to be where my line of symmetry is. So down here, remember I just scaled by 1s on the x-axis, is going to be down here at negative 1. Looks like there's negative 2 there. Let's do here. X equals negative 1.75 is where my lowest point's going to be. So that should help out my graph. If I wanted to find out what the y value of this would be for the vertex, is I would plug in negative 1.75 and I'd plug that in for x. That's going to be messy just because this is a decimal and, you know, this is kind of a complicated quadratic. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to use that to help me get this graph looking like a parabola. So vertex is probably somewhere around here. And this, we just want to repeat this through the other root to make this look like as accurate of a parabola as we can be. So it doesn't look 100% accurate because, again, we're just sketching it. But this is a pretty good job of explaining what that function does. So try out these problems down below. We have 4 more problems for you to try. quadratic, 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 quadratic here. Some are written in standard form. Some you're going to have to flip around a little bit to make it written in standard form. And another, don't work too hard on one of these. It should be pretty easy to factor one of these. That's a different one. So pause the video now and give these a shot. And you'll unpause it later and see how you do.